the teenage boy Olufemi, was very brilliant, outstanding academically. He completed his secondary school, where he held several leadership roles, including being a senior prefect. He also got a scholarship to proceed to a higher institution. He completed his A-levels at Government College, Ibadan, and then proceeded to University of Ife, where he earned a bachelor's degree in economics.
Eme, wo mu eme ne suku me, so olorun sa mi eme lo join ise sugbon fe mi o lo si university o lo ichesi o ko le ichesi o bo university ko to wa di ko na jade o bere si sise.
Olufemi's love for nation building, along with his keen sense of responsibility and the love for the development of the next generation, made him to reject several corporate job offers as a return to honor his scholarship commitment to his alma mater. Oh, what a man of integrity. He went back to Igbo-Elerin Grammar School, where he became a teacher in the 60s and 70s. Teaching was a lifestyle, not just in the classroom. His passion for the nation and love for education later led him into joining the civil service of the Oyo State government, where he served meritoriously till he retired in the year 2001.
He was a teacher, and you know them, all the knowledge he has been imparting to others. And that is why so many people so much loved him, because he's a loving man himself.
As you said, sir, he means a teacher ni CAC Modern School Andugwa. Mbemo le meti se said, sir. So we ti yan po. Ehn. Tori kini ni chesi to se Government College lo ti lo se. Lo ti se Chelsea, we ti ku le Chelsea Obo University. O npo university, me to se gba si ise ijoba secretariat nu.
He was a man that is well respected when he was in service. Because as the former director of schools, I've been to his office. Baba is such that he doesn't discriminate who comes into his office. He's always ready to help people. And you know, in the civil service, there are a lot of briefcases. But with him, there was a smooth running of the schools in Oyo State in his tenure as the director of schools.
Through networking of his immediate elder sister, he met his wife, his first and only wife, Mama Selina Abiola Fadipe Ni Diji, a virtuous woman born in Ibese, a Laro area of Ogun State, a primary school teacher who came to Ibadan through the lifting of God in search of greener pasture and self-development, became the wife of Papa Olufemi. The two lovebirds got married in 1968 in Ilaro, Ogun State. Theirs was a marriage bathed in friendship, mutual respect, shared vision and love. The two of them were so close.
Iye dada Femi, Femi ibayan ja nibi to je nibi to Femi dade to tutu de sin so eh won fe yawo fun ni ko mo bin ba soro ma fe yawo fun ni won oju awa to ko mefa won 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 tan mo yan mo bin ba soro won mo bin ba soro won fe yawo fun ni so won gba tolorun sa nu re eje re l'olorun pe se fun ni yawo yawo t'olorun fun o je omobirin to da ah o wulo o si ko yan mara
yawo daada ni. Papa Olufemi remained a devout Christian all the days of his life. He served Christ in different capacities in his family church, Christ Apostolic Church, Itabale Olugbode, Ibadan, where he was a leading member of the men's group, Egbe Ina Olorun. He rededicated his life to Christ at Full Gospel Businessmen Fellowship International Meeting in Ibadan, where God reignited a fresh fire and zeal for purpose in him and his wife. They became committed life partners. They served God with unity of spirit. They were part of the team that started the prime chapter of Full Gospel Businessmen Fellowship International in Agodi, Ibadan. The chapter is still thriving till today and has even birthed a few more chapters.
Baba was the first president of my chapter. He was the first president of my chapter, and under him, under his administration then, they gave birth to like one or two chapters under him. And when he left, leaving the chapter to become the field representative. So, but being the field representative of the chapter, I mean of the Full Gospel, about 6 to 10 chapters is under his administration. So, Baba was a great man. He was a great man. Talk anything Bible, Baba is ready to support. So he was a very great man in Full Gospel. Even is a member of a THP, that is the happiest people on earth. So he's well known in the Full Gospel, both in the state, in the federation, and even across the nations, because he worked very hard in his time. He worked very hard. And Papa supported us morally. Whenever you needed correction, anything you do that is maybe you needed to be corrected, Baba won't leave anything untouched. He would talk to you like his own child. He would talk to you whenever you needed to be blamed. He will blame you and he will correct you. He will even draw you back to himself.
He was a field rep long before I even became a chapter president. One thing that I know about him was I've had the privilege to minister several times in his chapter. After the ministration, he will not only talk to me and to encourage me, he will correct that while you are saying this, you should have said this. And I wonder, because not many people do such. You just, when somebody ministers, you just feel, the Lord is your strength and things like that. But he will correct. And another thing, with his age, he was consistent. You will see him at most of the chapter meetings. And that is one thing that I will miss, jovial, or he was humorous. For every little thing that you say, he sees the good side of it.
He loved God. Baba would tell me he's going to church, that he's one of the choir. He's one of the choir in his church. So Baba won't leave anything untouched when it comes to Bible, when it comes to church or fellowship.
His journey of faith took him to Living Spring International Ministry, where he became the head of the men's ministry in the church. Along with his wife, he was ordained an elder. In fact, his wife, Mama Abiola Fadipe, was part of the team that planted and started a new branch of that ministry in Monoton area of Ibadan. This church branch is still very vibrant and has opened up more branches today.
I knew him as a pastor in Full Gospel. After some years, he had been inviting us to Full Gospel. After we established our church, he decided to join our church. He joined the church where I worked as the national administrator. Being knew ourselves before then, I knew Baba to be a man of principle, a man of character, and integrity. A man that you put something in his hand that he didn't need to look back. He will do it as if it's my own. Ditto to when he joined the ministry. At the time we went to ordain, we called him to be ordained as pastor, Papa of the Territory. For the fact that he was still the pastor in full gospel.
I'm going to start with Baba's way of praising God. Baba will say, praise ye the Lord. And we always answer, hallelujah. We give glory to God for Papa's life and the life which has been set by my husband. Baba has been such a wonderful man. And there was a time in the ministry we were before that they were searching for who to lead the men. And even though I'm not a man, when I had to speak with my husband, I was like, why can't they put Baba Fadipe? He has everything to be able to lead this man. And Baba didn't know what went behind, what was being discussed behind him concerning his nomination being the head of the men's group called Bezali. And Baba spoke with me, said, and I told him, I said, yes, daddy, you will do it. He said, but all these men, I said, yes, daddy, you have everything that you can to really lead them. And I'm so happy that during the period he led the Bezali, which is the men's group of former church, Baba did excellently well. That irrespective of who you are, with the wisdom the Lord has given unto him, he was able to paddle the canoe of Bezali successfully.